Well, honey, are you ready to feed some calves?
Mm-hmm.
How's Bubs this morning?
Doing good.
That little bear outfit is too cute.
So we're gonna go feed some cake first. We've got the group we're feeding is 83 head. We're feeding them 3 pounds of cake per animal. So 83 times 3 is what, 24? 240 pounds? 240 pounds, a bucket weighs 25 pounds. We need about 10 buckets. Yeah. Wow. Did you do the math?
No.
No?
No, I didn't.
All right, Bubs, let's go feed some cows.
Yep.
You want to go dump that in the other side?
I don't know if I can. Huh?
You got her. You're tough. Good job, honey. We figure it's time that Silas meets Trump for the first time. Right? He hasn't met him, has he?
I don't think so.
I don't think so either. Trump will come say hi. I'm sure Dirk will. Hey, buddy.
Say hi.
Want to say hi to Silas? There you go. How about you, Trump? Come say hi.
Yeah.
You might be teaching Silas how to ride one day, Trump. In a few years. Looks like your eye looks pretty good there, bud.
Mm-hmm.
Let me look. Yeah, it does. Good.
So we've got haystacks where each of the groups of cows are. As you guys have seen at this place, we've got kind of a turkey problem.
So here we have some grain bales that the turkeys are just tearing apart. This here used to be all bales and they've pretty much picked it through and eaten everything, so there's no bales left. And they would have done that to these bales too, but we put some turkey net wrap on that they can't really pick through very well. But this, my grandpa and dad, this actually used to be where they had the feedlot before
we have the feedlot that we have now. And the turkeys used to be a really big problem for them then too, because they had a bunch of hay up here and corn. So the game fishing parks would come out with big net traps and trap hundreds of them and go transplant them other places. And they'd give my dad like some rubber bullets to scare them off. But the turkeys just come back every year.
Mm-hmm.
They've got free food, so you can't really blame them.
No.
But I don't know.
They probably wouldn't make it through the winter if it weren't for people feeding them like we do on accident. But.
Hey, buddy, waking up?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
What's wrong, bud? Want to feed some cake?
Want to feed some cake?
Hey, get out of here. I know you want cake. Getting a little snotty. These heifers are still learning what cake is, so I'm dumping it on top of the hay, that way they can find it. Once they learn about it, know they like it, they'll be looking for it every day. Just gonna kind of keep an eye on how much the cows are eating. I fed them these bales yesterday and they did not eat it up at all, so they left a lot, so I'm gonna feed them a lot less today. Hey, this is our other one nice cow, number 16. We'll get some cake and Damaris can hand feed him. Hi.
Hi. I'm a mama like you.
Here you go. Jodi, eat out of your hand. She's a little scared of you yet.
I know.
Here, I'll warm her up
to
you.
All right.
Come on, honey.
Number one.
Yeah, the very first cow. There. So here, now she'll eat out of your hand. Silas want to feed her.
I don't know if he can.
She might eat him. He kind of looks like a big piece of cake. Hey, come on. Get out of there. You're getting mobbed. Clear.
So Carson's out feeding. Finished feeding the cows this morning, and I'm gonna make some pannekoeken. So this is essentially a Dutch pancake. It's really simple. So right now I have the oven preheated to 400. So while it's doing that, I'm gonna get my pan ready. So I think, is this a 9x13? Not really sure. So you wanna get yourself a pan and then some butter. So I'm gonna take, you can use the whole stick. I'm just gonna use half. Or a little more than half the stick of butter. We're gonna put it in the pan and then put it right into the oven. So what we need for this recipe is about 8 to 12 eggs, some flour, milk, and I use a little bit of vanilla as well as butter. So I'm gonna take my butter. Again, I'm just gonna use about half to 3/4 of the stick of butter. We're just gonna put it right onto our pan and then we wanna put it into the oven to start melting and getting nice and brown. So I'm just gonna put this right into the oven. I don't wait for the oven to preheat. I just stick it right in there and let it melt. So in a bowl, I'm gonna take, we'll start with our eggs. So I'm gonna use 10 eggs today. Yeah, again, you can use 8 to 12 eggs. It seems like a lot, but it makes a whole pan. So I'm just gonna crack all these into my bowl. I've got 10 eggs here in the bowl and I'm just gonna take my whisk and whisk those all together. Just break them up. Again, you can use either mix it by hand or I know Carson's mom puts everything in a blender and just blends it all together. I actually got this recipe from her. And I know she uses a lot of eggs. The more eggs you use, the thicker the pancake is gonna be. Cup of flour. flour here. Flour. And we'll just put that right in. And mix it all up. Cup of milk. Any milk will work. I haven't tried it with almond milk or oat milk or anything, but you can sure give it a try and let me know if it works. I assume it would, but. So we just want to incorporate this all, get most of the lumps out. Again, this is where a blender would come in use. So I'm just gonna keep mixing this to get all the lumps out. Now that we've got most of the lumps out, I am just gonna put a splash of vanilla in there. This is completely optional. I just think it adds a nice smell and taste, of course. So just mix that in and then wait for our butter to brown in the oven. I'm gonna take our pan out of the oven and we can just kind of move the butter around in the pan. Very hot. And then what we're gonna do is take our batter here and we're gonna pour it right into the pan, just like that. And get it all in there. All right, so now that we've done that, we're gonna put it directly back into the oven. Now I might need two hands for this. And we are gonna put this right into the oven. Okay, so we're gonna let this bake for about 25 to 30 minutes on 400, and we'll be back when it's done.
So I guess Damaris made some pannekuchen, which is my favorite breakfast, but she's feeding Silas right now, which I probably won't show, or I might get banned from YouTube. But I'm gonna take the pannekuchen out. It looks awesome. You guys, you need to try this if you haven't. It's delicious, so I'm gonna take it out of the oven.
It's a big one.
Look at that. It's gonna be delicious. It's my favorite breakfast, guys. You gotta try it. I promise you, you won't be disappointed.
I gotta mention how to eat it.
Huh?
I can mention it.
What do you mean?
You can sprinkle it with powdered sugar and you eat it with maple syrup.
Did you guys hear her? You can sprinkle it with powdered sugar.
Yep.
Or maple syrup, which is how I like it.
And or. Drizzle with maple syrup.
Yeah.
Look how beautiful. It'll settle a little bit, but it's delicious. We love it.
My mom always told me it was like a Dutch recipe. I don't really know much about it, but we like it. If any of you are from Holland and you make this stuff, you should let us know. I've seen a couple people comment they're from Holland. And I know, well, our side of the family is mostly Dutch and English. Damaris is very German. Like, her parents still speak German, fluently German. So you guys didn't make this stuff growing up, did you?
No, did you make? I never heard of it, actually.
You never had heard of it? No. But if you're from Holland, let us know if you guys actually make this or if it's just some Americanized thing, but it's good. We love it. Oh yeah. Beautiful.
Make the plate look pretty too. Mm-hmm. You want some, honey?
Sure. You want some?
Yeah. That's good. Thanks.
You better get a bite.
Mmm. That's good, honey.
Yeah, so the more eggs that you put in there, the thicker it's gonna be.
So it can get real thick, can it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's the perfect thing after feeding some cows. Try it out. Bless you, buddy. Well, thank you guys for coming along today. We do really appreciate it. Hope you're all doing well. And we'll see you in the next one.